Okie dokie, gentlemen, are we all here ready to fucking go? I asked y'all a question!
As I reveal my giant monkey!
That's not as funny as you thought it was, boy!
God, I thought he meant penis!
I swear, the only thing I hate more than weaklings...
Hey! I'm speaking, soldier! Don't fucking speak unless you're smart, you fucking nerd! What are we gonna do? We're gonna blur!
The talk show at the end of the week.
Space is big.
Star Citizen base.
It's really big.
Round table.
All right, what the hell are we doing? There we go. We're live. It is going to be a standard thing every time, like, the camera's all going to be fucked up. But, it's okay.
It is what it is.
We don't have a Gentile. So.
He's too busy having a life.
That thing can go away. Oh, no. Is he?
Well, I think he's looking for cheap deer. Cheap meat for the next year.
Not in the supermarket?
Nope.
Well, you could do that, but it's a lot cheaper to get it yourself.
Oh.
Well, look at it this way. It's much fun, more fun to get it yourself.
Takes a lot of time, though, yeah.
He's probably like everybody else hunting. Probably going to go get brand new equipment every time he goes out for the yearly hunt. It's like new chairs, new feet radiator for heat his bloody feet because he claims it's cold.
Yeah, cold.
New rifle, more ammunition, rifle
Did
for the other
rifle?
Kid.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure we're...
When does he not get a new
that,
rifle?
That deer is expensive. Equally, it's like, oh, I'm only going to spend the money this year.
Well, he doesn't have to get new gear, you see.
Mm-mm. You can buy new
That's
ships, too.
He has everything. Yeah, no, he's done with ships. I think that's safe to say.
Yeah, he's well good. Done with ships.
Yeah.
It's got to be something really, really...
Now watch when Citizen Con happens.
We're hitting to buy a new ship.
Let's smack the world with another crazy
ass... the battle cruiser. Battle cruiser.
A completely new class.
I don't think he'd buy a battle cruiser.
No?
I don't think he'd buy that. I don't know what he likes.
Something for hunting.
He's a space trucker.
Ah, okay.
This is great.
So I think
that's
he has.
Me. Well,
I'm pretty sure if you give him something like the Freelancer Miss, just bigger. So bigger Freelancer Miss with a lot of guns, a lot of missiles, maybe some torpedoes and cargo space. That would be his work home. Basically, like Mad Max trailer.
Mad Max
trailer. There you go. That's a great explanation. I like that.
Are you playing? Is that PTU?
That's the PTU.
And he's going to go to the arena. He's going to
check it all out. Convention Center.
Whee!
There we go. That's big enough. Okay.
Nothing happened this week.
Someone in the Discord can't find his Renegade cargo vest in the game. Even though he has the Ranger.
I don't even know what that is, so I couldn't help even if I wanted to.
It's a vest you get with the Ranger.
A particular Ranger.
Yeah, it's a nice vest.
Well, it's a cargo vest. Doesn't really work like the...
Like the armor one?
The other one does, which is supposed to, but... Work in progress.
So,
for those
who missed it, there was a article interviewing Chris Roberts this week.
Really?
Yeah.
So that's the article. And it's It's a good read. And for those of you who are reading impaired or too lazy or whatever that ails you, here's the video explaining it.
Yeah, it was interesting. It's always good to hear him about his vision for or what he thinks will happen in the future. The whole gaming industry rather than just Star Citizen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because one of the reasons why I backed this whole thing was to push
the shit show.
The boundaries. Now, to push the boundaries of gaming, which has been stuck in a rut for the past several years. And consoles don't help.
No. Consoles are definitely a handicap.
Yeah, so it restricts the gaming industry, I think, within a certain tech, and don't push it far enough where I think it should be. And I genuinely believe that we are easily a couple of decades behind where we should be.
Oh, yeah, because of convenience, right? People want things that are convenient.
Mm.
So they're willing to sacrifice the progression.
So one of the progression they talked about was, so instead of having 400 server and each server having 100 or 200 people on it, and those people can't see players on the other servers, if they mash all this together, you know, server mashing, you could then have all 4,000 people on the server, single server, or 40,000 people in the same world at the same time. Now, as he continues, we're not the only one working on that. There's sort of that thing when you won't be able to go onto a single player game that I think can be really compelling. You know, he's talking about MMOs. And he's also mentioning that later on that Amazon is also working behind the scenes without much ado about it.
Sold
on the
out.
Same technology.
What happened to all those things?
Yeah, they took them out of there. They probably didn't want people to see them.
What do you mean see them?
Like they normally do. They always leave something in there. It's like, oh, we weren't supposed to show that.
No. That would be too dumb for them. I'm pretty sure that they may have just been like...
Did you say something was too dumb for a company?
Are you serious? We saw everything.
How would that even happen? A designer was like...
You saw...
Like a level designer was like, oh, let's put all those t-shirts in there. And then someone was like, no, you can't show those. And how does that work? I wouldn't imagine they just put them in there on purpose initially.
Maybe.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I would not put it past CIG to deliberately drop leaks and...
Oh, we have a picture. One second.
Yeah, stuff. I saw it. Hang on.
Just to get the...
No, hang a second.
The excitement going.
There was too much chat in the Star Citizen channel. It's all the way up.
No. Where's that? I get it. Get one for it. Copy link.
They're just shirts and hats.
More than just shirts and hats.
This is the stuff we want in real world.
No, I see shirts and hats. I don't see anything else.
Use your imagination.
Look at that. Argo Astronautics. I want every one of them in real world.
The Argo... I like the Argo stuff.
Okay.
The color and the logo are pretty cool.
Something else they talked about is in this article.
Yeah.
Was yeah, I'm just ignoring you. That's fine.
Thank you.
That's fine. I'm used to it. He talked about, you know, what the average ping is, you know, there's 20 milliseconds to talk to the server, and there's 20 milliseconds to get back, and then there's your own client lag and the server lag, and then blah, blah, blah. And then, you know, on top of that, there's a lot of cheating, and, you know, you can get to 70, 100 plus milliseconds, and it feels laggy, etc. Then he mentioned something that I found interesting. The cool thing with Stadia, Google's new...
The what?
Server lag.
He seemed to like that, didn't he?
There is almost no time difference to talk between servers and clients, and there's really any difference between the two. The quality of a multiplayer experience will increase because you have much less latency, you won't have any issue with cheating, and you eliminate the issues you get with lag. So what he's talking about basically, I think, through a very, very suspect way of saying it, is that they're working on some sort of, and this is my take on it. I don't care what anybody else takes on it. This is my take on it. I think they're working on moving a lot of the traditional, this is the client, this is the server, they need to talk to each other in a traditional way. And the client, your character moves on the client and then transmit that movement to the server. I think your client is going to not have, is going to be involved in the graphics part of it. It's going to be involved in the generation of whatever's been shown and the input that's being done. But your client will be moving around on the server. Your client is not going to be moving around on your client. It's going to be moved to the server. That's going to reduce, it's going to increase the, a little bit lag for you. But that's why they're allowing you to connect to the servers locally in Europe, locally in the United States, locally in East Asia, West Asia, and so forth, right? In Australia. So they're going to have, I think they're moving, this is in part the technology that made MechWarrior Online, or whatever the fuck it's called, very playable, because you could play against a lot of different time zones, a lot of millisecond, you know, in the hundreds of milliseconds, normal time difference, and you would still feel that you were had control of your character or mech, and when you hit something, you hit it, and it, because it was done on the server, or is done on the server, partly. Not completely. And I think that's the solution they're going for. It's a partial transference of, it's not Stadia, if you know what I mean, because on Stadia you can play that on a browser because the rendering is done on the server. Not so here. The rendering is done on your computer, but wherever the client is moving, it's moving on the fucking server. You know what I mean?
Yeah, all the calculations are done on the server. And yeah, then you just get the results back.
And this is what I've been waiting for. This is what I've been waiting for a long time to hear. Because this is one of the most crucial bit that we're going to be having to, or that had to be done for this game to be playable. And everybody that's played any sort of large game, multiple entity, multiple NPC game, and tried to aim in a first-person shooter or a third-person shooter that's alternating in first-person scoping and stuff like this, you know it has to be done. Mm. And if you reference that to the previous number, that not even if you don't see 4,000 or 40,000 characters on that world at the same time because of multiple different technologies, all of that is still running in the background. There's no fucking way your computer is going to do it. I don't care if you super cooled it. You know, if you're running it on liquid nitrogen, doesn't really matter. You won't be able to run it on your PC. You need a cloud-based server-controlled client to be able to run that. And I think that... this, as bland as this article seems to somebody, it's
damn,
actually kind of major.
Long.
It'll be interesting to see if they can pull it off. I mean, they eventually will, I'm sure, because the technology is there, right? The bandwidth has become ubiquitous, like you said, and then so it's just a matter of getting that information back to you in a way that works, right? Mm. So like one of the things that Oculus is doing, right, is they released the Oculus Quest, which is a standalone headset, right? It's a phone processor. It does its stuff. You play it. They're rolling out an update where you're going to have a cable, and it's a fiber optic cable, believe it or not, that you can actually, you'll connect your Oculus Quest to the computer, and you'll play the computer-based games, and it will transmit that information to your headset, Well, a lot of the work is getting done on a computer, and it's basically rendering it as a video and sending it to you.
Mm-hmm.
And to be able to compensate for the lag and all that other kind of stuff is similar premise. So I'm pretty sure they'll eventually get that, because you gotta, I mean, it's just a matter of, you know, how much of a difference is it going to be between someone that has 20 milliseconds versus someone that has 120 milliseconds, right? How much of an impact is that going to be in the gameplay for that person that has the 120 versus the 20? It's drastic now. It's huge. The big advantage having the shorter
time. I think the good thing here is that they're not going to be transferring video. They're going to just be transferring the client's going to be determined. The client position is going to be determined by the server. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So when you're moving around with your character using WASD on your keyboard, you're talking to your own machine, but you're also talking to the server. So your machine gets a permanent update about where your client is, instead of your client updating the server about where your character is. So your character is determined, position is determined by the server, but it's still rendered. It's still cohesioned. So you feel like if you do like this with WSD, you're still able to do that and feel like you have a good feel for the character. Mm-hmm. It's just that it also eliminates this fucking thing. You know what I mean?
Right.
WASD all the time. That's a perfect way of saying, you know, if you overload the server, the character is just going to be standing there. I want an emote where your character just start dancing if you do WASD too fast.
That would be funny.
That would be funny. You know what I mean? It's
yeah, I get it.
It's to combat cheating. And I call that using game mechanic that isn't intended to be something. You know what I mean?
Well, people are always going to do that.
Yeah, so we just eliminate the possibility of doing that. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I mean, do you really want the characters to go around in the city because they're not capable of doing anything else like this? Over and over and over and over, back forth. Like in a dance over there? Or do you want the character to actually move? What does your immersion bug says? You know, what do you want from other players?
Right. No, I get it.
So yeah.
And give me,
I know people are screaming at the screen there now and saying, how dare you? You know, it's like the fly boys saying, how dare you saying that missiles should work? You know?
Yeah. It's a disadvantage to them, so they don't want you to do that. Hey, Kimmy, you can play 40K at 60 frames. You just have to have a PC that can do it. So that's going to be client specific, not necessarily whether or not the game can support it. I'm pretty sure Star Citizen will be able to support 40K at 60.
Yeah, if this technology is the technology that would allow it,
mm-hmm.
because it moves so much of the data from the client to the server.
Yep.
So. It's just going to be about the rendering. So if you have the graphic card, the monitor, and a proficient enough CPU and memory, you'll be fine.
Yeah.
It's about what can you preload of textures now, mm-hmm. instead of how many AI can you process at the same time.
Right.
And that's been the huge, biggest problem between talking between a client and a server has been all the AI servers or AI that's on the server. So if a server responds 200, 400, 500 AI, you can see the server time just go, the server FPS just creeps down to 1 or 2 or 3, right? And yeah, I think that's going to be a much bigger help because you don't need all that data transferred and then generated. So it's, I think there's... there's a lot in this.
Mm-hmm. So let's talk about predictions. Let's formalize what we think is going to happen with this event. This weekend.
Speculate?
Yeah.
Just a little bit. We never speculate.
We and I were having a discussion, I think the other day, that the actual show will start, not the Citizen Con itself, but the in-game show will start either Thursday or Friday. The expo will start either Thursday or Friday.
Yeah.
I'm of the opinion, no.
Is there a choice where I don't give a fuck?
Yeah, if you don't give a fuck, you can say
You can press that button there, Qantas. Press it there.
What about you, Ralph? Do you think it's going to start before CitizenCon?
I said that, well, CitizenCon always, I'm pretty sure, will include a ship being revealed, and that will usually probably coincide at the same day.
Same server.
No, I'm not. Jesus. I mean, I don't have you. It's PTU.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, that'll mean that when they do reveal that ship, that ship will, at that day, or maybe the day after, will also be available in the expo to check out. So I'm assuming they may have it at least a model ready already.
Yeah, but do you think the expo is going to start on the same day as the Citizen Con, or do you think it'll start before?
I don't know, at or before, either one. Not after, though.
Well, obviously. So pick one. Obviously. Do you think it'll start Thursday or Friday, or do you think it'll start on Saturday?
Friday?
You think it'll start on Friday?
Yeah. Okay, they may have even something
before. Starts before. Okay, yeah. It's reasonable. So two for before, one for at, and one for don't give a fuck. Okay.
Both neutral.
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 Okay. Let's go down the list of like rumors and stuff like that, right? So new star system. Yes, no, or indifferent.
New?
New star system that we can actually go to.
No.
Like that's the caveat that we can actually go to.
Definitely not.
This year, maybe.
I'm going to be safe and saying no.
Okay.
This year, maybe. Maybe not at...
No, maybes.
This point. I think that they might show us something that we're going to get later this year. Or just over the new year.
So, since you're in the game, do me a favor. Go over to one of the garbage cans.
This guy has the hats.
So this is something that I saw, which was very interesting. Go find a garbage can. One of you guys, go find a garbage can.
I'm looking at it. If the NPC let me stop.
There's one right here too.
All right, look inside the garbage can. Look in the garbage.
Unveils new system.
Yeah, that.
What is it?
Yeah, it says that there's a new system that's unveiled. So the question is that implying that we're going to get a new system that we don't know of in the game at all? Or is it a system that they're going to actually let us go to? So
I may just reveal
I have
in
mentioned
lore,
in the past that it should be very easy for them to build Pyro with like minimal stuff. We said that version 1 of jump points will be on rails. So it's just a transition from one to the other. And then there's the rumors of the new system and all that other stuff. So I'm kind of on the fence post with this one. I think that
on rails.
We're going to do that, but
on rails.
I'm kind of on Tio's side where it's like probably not until the end of the year.
And then it's going to be on rails between systems.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It'll definitely be on rails. Definitely be on rails. I think version 1 is just going to get that transition working to get us between the two systems. Because they probably need to test that. Especially if you're going to be going between systems in Squadron 42. So I'm going to say yes, but towards the end of the year.
Sounds realistic.
So, Realm, what was your take on a new system?
Not playable.
Not playable.
They
okay.
may reveal something in the side of lore. I mean, okay. that thing happened in the past too, like the whole Vega invasion, but it doesn't really it didn't really impact us as players because it didn't matter in the game itself. It was just like a bunch of lore that, you know.
Very valid.
You didn't have to deal with it, so it's possible here they may do the same. It's like, okay, it's a new system revealed. It's cool. It's nice, but you won't be able to. It's not like it'll be in the game. I don't suppose it will. If they even do that.
That's an interesting little Easter egg
You went back and forth. At one time you were like, nothing happened. Then you kind of like, well, maybe it will happen.
No, it makes sense. As I said, the Test Squadron 42, Nebula's other asteroid tech, that kind of thing. But we've seen the asteroid tech being removed from the roadmap. So that's kind of slightly disappointing. In fact, we saw a lot of stuff vanishing off the roadmap.
I had to recover my account anyway.
So is that a...
So I'm going to be conservative and say no.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we got two no's and we got two maybe by the end of the year.
And still don't give a fuck.
And I don't give a fuck. All right, so let's see. What's the other things that have been going on? So there's been talk of the Pisces, which is the subship for the Crack.
The Carrick, yeah.
For the Carrick. So anybody think that that's going to be one of the new ships that they announce?
Subship.
It's one of the ships that come with snub fighter, snub whatever, exploration, snub ship, whatever. But it comes with the crack.
They never showed any pictures of the thing.
One that's going to be flying through smaller wormholes.
Yeah. So do you think that's going to be one of the newer ships?
The Carrick? Sorry.
No,
they've been talking about... Yeah, well... I think they're going to wait with that ship until the Carrick is out, unless they're going to be selling it as a single seater, which is makes sense that
Carrick's
they would,
in development,
right?
So yeah.
Well, the Carrick is supposed to be coming out. It's still on the roadmap, right?
Yeah.
So it's supposed to be coming out the end of this year, by 3.8, I think. So it would make sense to have the fighter.
Well,
or
if they're going if it's going to be sold as a separate, and then you can have it as a. Like the other ships that come with ships, right?
Mm-hmm.
Everything has been sold by themselves. I think if they're going to sell it, that wouldn't be a good ship. And
pickles.
But then again, there is nothing to do with that ship. You know what I mean?
Well,
it would be nice.
Reason though.
That would indicate that, okay, the ship is going to be on sale now, but you won't be able to use it until 3.8, and then you're going to be able to map or pretend to map on a Rails system, you know what I mean? Switch.
Yep.
Here's what I look like.
So, I just heard someone mention it. They said that they saw it in, or someone had seen it in the data mining. Since the Carrick is supposed to be coming out, and we haven't really seen a lot in regards to other ships, and it's supposed to be a small to medium sized ship. I'm going to say, yeah, I think we'll see it.
Yeah, there will be a small ship affordable for people. You know, the Arrow was very successful last year, and I think continues to be. So, small ships seems to do okay because, you know, people, it's within people's.
It's only $30.
Yep. LTI token.
I do expect a larger ship though.
Okay, let's talk about larger ship. So they said ships S. The question is, are they talking about just some of the ships that we already knew about that they're going to be talking about and how they went about developing them, or a combination of those ships and new ships, right? So One of the things people are speculating is another capital class ship of some sort. Mm-hmm. And you, Weehamster, have mentioned battle cruiser several times, which makes sense.
That's a goal, isn't it?
Yep. And then I was thinking originally maybe the Pegasus, but I don't know who the creator is for that. Did they ever say who it was for?
No, it's RSI, but...
is it RSI?
No. Yeah.
Yeah, no, okay, that's too big. No.
That's too big?
That's a big beast. No, that's definitely going to be something similar to the Bengal. You know, that's... One might be found abandoned in the middle of nowhere, and an Norg is going to have to repair that.
I don't think so. Because it's an escort carrier fighter. It's supposed to carry
about the Polaris.
The
Pegasus.
Javelin is $3,000 now. I guarantee the Pegasus will be $5,000. There's absolutely no doubt about it. This is a major Org thing that you can hold about 20, 30 ships on it. Nah.
They've never been afraid to charge extraordinary amounts.
No, they haven't, but I think that's a bit too far.
Okay, so you think the Battlecruiser is going to be more in line with what? The Idris or the Javelin? Probably the Javelin,
In between. It's an in-between.
Well, what's a Battlecruiser? Is it bigger than a...
It is in between. It's similar to an Australia. It's just with bigger guns and slower.
It's basically what it is. Bigger, heavier, but it's not as big as a battleship. You know, it's in between a battleship.
In between, yeah.
And
it will need protection. It will need protection.
Well, if it's bigger than a Javelin,
everything that's big need protection. We agree on that. Can we agree on that simple premise?
Okay.
So,
but what I mean by that is
the Hammerhead is a good size that doesn't need its own protection. You know what I mean? The Hammerhead is it has enough capability to shoot down torpedoes. It has capability to shoot down single-seater fighters. Doesn't need that much protection. You know, it would be advisable, but it's a ship that's meant to protect. It's a support ship, support class for bigger ships. And the Polaris is, although it's not that much bigger, it's much more need of protection because it's more a directed spear against big... Mm. It's like a glass cannon against big ships, right? So I think that anything that's Idris class and bigger will need protection.
Yeah. But, so, okay, Battlecruiser... We'll go with Battlecruiser as the next capital-sized ship that they probably will release. And
$3,000 to $4,000, by the way.
It's definitely going to be more. Yep.
Yeah.
It's going to be a $3,000 to $4,000ship. But $3,500. I don't know if they're
big.
You know why $3,500?
Oh, no, I know the price.
We're touching on an upper limit.
Yeah.
Bigger guns. That's simple, isn't it?
Well, here's the question.
Smaller ship, maybe.
Smaller ship, bigger guns.
Yes.
So here's the question, right? The Javelin was released to us with no weapons, right?
Yeah.
Because they said it's too overpowered. It's not something that we want people to start off the game with.
That's right.
It's an org ship. We want them to work up to it. So let's assume that the Battlecruiser is going to be the ship. Is it going to fall under the same restrictions where it's not going to have any weapons?
That's a good point. Yeah, that's a good point. It will require an org.
If they can place it in the same class
as
the Idris. No, the one above the Idris. I don't even remember what it's called.
The Javelin.
Okay. If you can place it in the same class, same price bracket, it's smaller than a Javelin, but has more guns, for instance. More capabilities, but it is more vulnerable, faster, you know, stuff like this. That would make it in the same price bracket. Any reason they find for, you know, placing it, regardless of what ship it is, if it goes much beyond the Javelin, I don't think we're going to see it as for sale.
So they would have to unequip it to be that kind of price. Because if you put the weapons on it, then it's going to be
even
more expensive.
Yeah,
10,000.
Yeah. There's few people that will buy that. Miko being one of them, but not me, that's for sure.
Hell no.
And Steve, man, I agree. The Polaris is more like a submarine because it's a torpedo boat.
Yeah.
So Brightmas says you can't even aim at torpedoes. How are you going to shoot them down? They already talked about this at length. You will be able to target them with radar, and through targeted or radar, that will spread throughout any ship, and you will be able then to pop up as a target you can shoot at. So this just not the technology that's in properly yet. Same thing with missiles. Missiles will be targetable at some point.
They're just harder to hit because they're faster.
Yeah.
Okay, so we talked capital ship. We talked new system.
Can I also throw in there the places, which is the stump ship for the stump ship.
Any other ships, do we think?
Yeah, I think there's going to be a medium or large ship similar to, say, between a Cutlass or a Constellation, that kind of size.
To do what?
Good question, but that's again, it's just an overall price point I think that they will be aiming at.
So you think we're going to have three different new ships for the different price ranges?
Easily, yeah.
Small, medium, and large?
Yeah, well, I mentioned before that the Mark II Hornets.
That's right. We got the Hornets could fill that gap.
Yeah, so that could be one. I still think it's going to be another ship. No, I don't think they've done that. There's no excuse for them to not do it, but... I don't expect that at all. They should have done it by now, but no.
Okay.
This is something we're not expecting. They definitely have a few tricks up their sleeve. So.
Okay. Back to data mining. They have the city for Crusader in the data mining.
Oh yeah.
Orsiris.
Yes. No. That's just information for probably the star map. We might be getting updated star map. But, I don't think so. No. Well, it's not Crusader.
It's over Crusader.
Yeah, unless they're going to spring a surprise and say, surprise, here's Crusader.
It fell off the roadmap, didn't it? It was on a roadmap for three...
No, four.
It's on four.
It's still on four?
It's on four.
Okay, then so maybe right. It's just information that's being fed.
Yeah, yeah. That's all it is. And they updated the microtech as well. Slightly disappointed the moon's being pulled. Are we going to crash into this? Disappointed the moons are being pulled.
They're removing the moons because they're focusing on the new tech.
I don't know how that's going to work. How are you going to have a system with no moons?
Well, no, it's... Who cares? Sorry, not to make it sound like your point is valid, but... we have plenty of moons
right
now.
You said your part is invalid.
I don't like you anymore.
That's okay. A lot of people don't like me. There's plenty of moons. We got more than enough moons right now to keep us occupied. We got so much area to keep us occupied that we can't visit all of it. The tech is probably being applied to all the current planets and moons, which is going to bring those to a new level, right? The fact that we don't get three extra moons, but we get a planet I'd rather have the planet than the moons, because most of the moons are just little fillers for some missions, right?
Mm-hmm.
There's usually nothing of serious content there, except unless you're a miner and they have some new resource. But for the most part, new moons, I don't think, is going to affect our overall experience in gameplay.
I wonder, are they going to do the old thing where they have a kind of placeholder, and if you go near the moon, you explode? Remember that?
Yeah, that'll work. Oh, God. That'll surprise a lot of people. Hey, let's go. What just happened?
Remember that was selling. Oh, that was hilarious. Yeah, couldn't go near the world. It's like disappointing.
You. As soon as you get close to the vandal attacks you.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Bam. No win scenario. Right?
Or the pirates, you know.
But the thing about the data mining, they did show stations. New orbital stations, which I thought was quite interesting.
Yes.
They seem to be equatorial orbit stations and polar orbit stations, as well as the usual Lagrange points.
Yep.
So there seems to be at least two stations per world.
I think they mentioned that in the Inside Live about how there's only like one planet that has those, and they wanted to kind of even that out a little bit more for balancing gameplay. And answers Zeus, his question is, why do you think they didn't just delay Microtech altogether? I think it's because it's a different biome, Zeus, that they want to test and make sure that it works. Plus, it's a dome city, a whole totally different experience. So I think it's more for just testing and getting it out because they can, versus delaying everything and just pissing everybody off to the extreme, where it's like, yeah, let's just give them what we got that works, which is kind of what they've been saying, is like, if we have the stuff, we'll give it to them.
There's a 100.
And then we don't, we just move on. Where's the 100? What are you talking about?
Well, this
adds there. Yeah, to that.
Yeah.
But we need,
maybe they'll put it
so
in
we
the
need to
expo.
Be able to play through wildlife, through different, you know, habitats and biomes that involves trees, bushes, rocks. We've tested rocks, but their placement on rocks is so bad and so not plausible that they also need to change that, you know. So I'm guessing that any new planet that comes is going to be a test, but for the fucking placement of the fucking rocks, including
roads,
all the other plants and
stuff. Dirt tracks.
Hopefully roads. That 4.0 will take care of that. I love you too, Zeus. I don't take it personal. But that's what I think. They just, you know, get it out there because they can. Yeah, hopefully the 4.0 gets rid of all those stupid rocks, because they are a pain in the butt and it makes driving such a
labor. All you need is
not
dirt
feasible
tracks.
Is the word
dirt
you're
tracks.
Looking for.
Dirt tracks. Or actual roads, you know, some shape.
Why would you put a road on a moon that's empty, that serves no purpose?
Because it makes it easier
especially
for
when
vehicles
you got spaceships.
To get around. This is what happened in the evolution of mankind. The time when we didn't have roads, so it was very difficult to get around. And when we had proper wheeled vehicles, we had to create proper roads. Yeah. So if we want to get around on a surface, we need to have roads.
But we got spaceships. Who needs...
No, you're still going to need land vehicles. So
we have wheeled vehicles.
To some degree. To some
I'm not talking about proper smooth surface. I'm talking about off-road.
It's cleared of rocks, at least.
Yeah, it's flatter, no rocks.
See, Bright's with me. You tell you to go use your spaceship.
So what happens to your Ranger and your Cyclone? Like, they're useless at the moment.
What? Yeah.
You know?
There's a lot of other stuff.
If they're going to bring out the Ranger, they're going to have at least dirt tracks.
Well, don't the Rangers have the same kind of... don't they have the same kind of wheels as the Cyclones?
They do. Yeah. And they still are not impervious to rocks, so unfortunately.
That's true.
Yeah.
Can somebody tell me what Red Dead Online is?
Red Dead?
So, Red Dead Redemption...
Oh, okay.
They want to do an online or an MMO version of the game. So it's just like Grand Theft Auto.
Yeah.
So how many years are it going to take to do that one?
Is it out or is it in the development?
It's the online variant of Red Dead Redemption 2.
Development.
No.
But I'm sure they have a lot of that infrastructure already there. It's just a matter of, because they just probably copy like the GTA 5 engine.
But my question to anyone here or in the chat, has anybody played Red Dead Online, or is it something that is not available yet?
Not available yet. The expert.
It's Red Dead Redemption 2 Online, also known as Red Dead Online.
It's not out yet.
Why not? That was last week.
Was it last week?
Red Dead Redemption 2 is the PC version is out.
Yeah, including the online
console one.
Multiplayer.
Okay, including the one.
Okay, so it is out. Okay. Never mind. I'm wrong. So if you want to play Cowboys Online, there you go.
Yeah, but I heard it's not exactly stable. Nothing new.
The game itself.
So Radham,
hey, if you play Star Citizen, you'll fit right in.
Go on, Radham, tell them. Tell them all.
Well, I think... what? Star Citizen is more stable than Red Dead Redemption 2. Seriously. It's just...
Crashing that often?
No, I mean, just in performance. Everyone gets terrible frame rates. It doesn't matter what system you have. Mostly doesn't matter, but it's kind of unoptimized. I mean, granted, LUD does look really good, but I mean, Star Citizen looks really good. It runs better in alpha.
So do you think, because they're two totally different genres, and I know that
Star Citizen
still needs a lot of plants and greenery and all that other stuff. But
yeah, obviously.
Would you say the level of, which one do you think is better looking, level of detail wise?
Oh, it's difficult. Vegetation obviously looks better, Red Dead.
Well, of course. Yeah, well, it's a finished game, but Yeah.
But the sheer scale of Star Citizen, you know, your horizon is much bigger and wider, and you can't even compare, really. Because everything like Red Dead, even though it looks beautiful, it's not that, the range is not that far away. Mm-hmm. You know, there's always a mountain or a hill that's in the way that's kind of chops your horizon a lot closer than say, compared to Star right. Citizen. So Star Citizen still will always be superior regarding that instance. But foliage is a big thing that's missing. There's no doubt about that. And yeah, Red Dead is miles ahead of better than that at the moment. But we know CryEngine. We've seen, you know, Crysis. We know what it's capable of. So sadly, we haven't seen it yet on Star Citizen.
On a large scale.
On a proper scale, and even what we have at the moment is a bit lethargic looking.
Why did I just saw someone run around with the hats on?
Because they probably bought it before they removed it.
Because you bought it before I have one.
I didn't realize they were actually available to buy back then.
Yep. I actually picked one up, was it yesterday or the day before?
They're going to throw this stuff up on live anyway, and you'll lose all that. Okay. I assume, yeah.
Oh, yeah. But someone did post in chat, they were curious. It's like, so if I buy it in-game, is it going to be persistent? Or are we going to lose it when they wipe again?
No. Well, no, it's only in the PTO, so we'll have to buy it.
When they put it in, so when they
open this
up in-game, in live.
I know, if you buy it live, it'll still in the game.
Probably get wiped.
Well, they will still be available in the game. It's not said that they won't be available.
No, you'll be buying it with real world money, like the subscriber stuff.
If you buy it with real world money, you keep it. But if you buy it with in game money, because it's AUEC,
will it get wiped? Of course it does. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. That's a place or anything.
Because I know a lot of people are in a rage.
Well, who said it won't be available after the expo anymore?
They'll sell it real world money.
Yeah. For sure.
But I mean, even for UEC, maybe they'll just put that stuff up in the Xaba outlet somewhere.
If they had any sense, they sell it in the real world as well.
Yeah, well, oh, manufacturer absolutely. Merchandise, that stuff looks nice.
Well, they've gotten pretty good at getting merchandise. I mean, I was completely surprised when they did not only the, was it the Nautilus? But they also did the Chairman's Club at the same time, right? They had the merchandise for both at the same time. Usually it's very limited what they roll out. So I can see them having all the shirts and all the hats real world. Although a lot of it probably won't get purchased. Because there's certain ones where you look at them and you're like, I don't know. Or they just, they don't have a very big fan base. They prefer other ships.
I don't know. People will have their favorite ships. But I think the way manufacturers that now make it as per order. So I don't think it'd be a lot of stock wasted like they have in the past with their previous.
I was impressed with the Argo. I actually saw that. I was like, you know, that's pretty cool. I like it.
Yeah. That's a real trucker's kind of hat almost.
And the t-shirt was pretty cool too.
Yeah, the t-shirt was nice. But I doubt it will be like that texture. It was like this texture.
Yeah, if they make the hats look like the hats are if they actually make real merchandise in the style of the hats in game, that will be very, very cool.
In that case, I'll want one of those Renegade Ranger vests.
Well, I don't know if they're going to do that. I want t-shirts and hats are probably a little bit easier.
I want this t-shirt. And I want it to be glow in the dark. Oh, no, wait.
I would definitely buy the Argo stuff as well as at least one or two of the other items, probably RSI. I don't remember if I saw anything else that really caught my eye that I said I had to have. I don't like that Aegis hat.
That's okay.
I don't like that.
I'm missing all the glasses though.
Yeah, the glasses is not in this. Maybe for the better, since they're quite buggy.
Are they?
They're really. Yeah, yeah.
Well, the glasses are in game in the live.
Well, you can see here, like my hair is clipped to the hat.
Oh yeah.
But the glasses are clipping really badly. Yeah. That's what we got.
What shirt are you wearing? Or vest or what? What are you wearing?
My Renegade vest.
Is that what you're wearing?
Yes, the Renegade. What is that? Renegade Racing. It's the one that came with the RC Ranger.
Mm-hmm.
So it looks pretty smart.
There's a cool back in it. Nice spine on it. It's a nice little detail, I have to say. Yeah, it's a cool one. You can also get the Renegade Cut, which is the suicide vest type thing. Why would you wear them? Seriously. But anyway. So that's for the punk heads out there. And then, of course, the cargo, which...
Yeah, the cargo's silly.
Yeah. Well, it's not silly, it's just you can't use it really apart from Hurston. And it wobbles.
But does it allow you to actually carry cargo when you go on a mission? You know, you get and actually allows you
to. I thought it did, but I haven't tried it yet. I'm not really near Hurston that often.
Because it's not like the other one that you buy with the armor that you actually can store stuff. When you're like mining and
I thought somebody said it did store. Hang on a second, let's see here. Yeah, save that. Now, let's see.
Does it show a number when you do that?
Yeah, it should come up here. So it's 120 SP, so that's not standard anyway.
No, actually, that's more than what you can normally carry, so it looks like it does work, I think.
I expect it to carry more than the other vest, the spacesuit.
Yeah.
It has more sections to it. Let's see. Yeah, wobbly.
N-Track is in the universe.
So you get an extra little section here at the bottom, so you should carry technically more, I think.
And on the top,
and it's
too.
Locked. I like the way you got a thumbprint. I hope that works. You need a thumbprint to open it.
Oh, that's cool. If nothing else, they always have their level of detail. I love it.
So we're a spacefaring bunch of creatures.
Oh, it's so much more stable.
Likes that genre. So what do you think of the... Has anybody played a new Star Wars thing?
Nope.
The single player?
Nope.
Anybody in chat? I'm going to play it eventually. It's just want to see if it's any good or not.
I think it's gotten some mixed reviews. When I saw the actual gameplay, when they first announced it, I wasn't overly impressed with it.
It is generic. How much can you do with push, pull, and jump, and lightsabers? I mean, if you don't like fighting with swords, you don't like fighting with lightsabers, right?
Right.
So, I find the whole... I really didn't like, until I played Kingdom Come, I didn't like fighting with swords in game because it kind of sucked.
Mm-hmm. Well, Kingdom Come has a nice system, though.
So. Yeah, Kingdom Come has a realistic system.
Yeah.
And I kind of like that. So, I'm not as against it as I used to be. So, I mean, Knights of the Old Republic, the old KOTOR games, you know, I really liked those. I even liked the MMO for a while. You know what I mean? I liked the whole Star Wars genre. So I'm just wondering if there's enough story there to take it home.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I know that, you know, there are people playing it, so...
Nobody's played it? Not even in chat? Or nobody wants to admit it because it's an EA game?
It's an EA game. Boo! Bad EA, bad Disney. Don't support them. Disney killed Star Wars. Boo!
Again, seriously don't give a fuck.
If the game's good,
I'll play it. If the game's not good, I'll still might try it. You know what I mean?
If they make it too political, no.
All right, so
have we run out of things to talk about?
I don't know. Have we covered everything? Let's do the nasty. Let's speculate, right?
Nasty.
Yeah, speculation is nasty.
It is.
What do you think is going to be new? What are they going to drop on us that's going to take our breaths away?
Well, they're just going to show off 3.8 firstly, anyway. So we're going to see the prison stuff, which is interesting. They don't have any prison.
Well, that's right, because they have the prison. They're actually building a prison.
There was an image there that popped up. These kind of monoliths, big buildings, and an automated prison, which is kind of interesting. God, imagine having an automated prison.
Droids? Ooh, we get droids?
No, I don't. I say you have to wear a suit. It looks like you have to wear a suit. Which is kind of interesting. I'm trying to curious where this world actually is. It looks like somewhere like Aberdeen or Ariel or something like that. Maybe Daymar. But the prisoners have to wear suits.
I wonder if that kind of ties into why they have to have a new system for us to go to. To be able to go to, because that's where the prison's going to be at.
Maybe. It makes sense for a prison to be in a system, though. Each system should have its own local prison, and then they'll probably be transferred to a more...
secure larger facility.
Yeah.
Do you think they'll just put it on one of the moons?
They do have a... Yeah, I think so. I think so. I think that makes sense, really. There's a couple of moons that have really nothing on it. So, thrown on Aberdeen, maybe, or Ariel would be would make sense just to increase traffic to those regions.
Yeah, put it on a planet that, or a moon that if you try to escape, you don't have a suit, you die.
That hopefully means bounty hunting. Now, so we might see bounty hunting.
I think we've already seen bounty hunting. What could they possibly do except give us like a stun gun or something? Or some animation where you actually pick up the guy and throw him into the ship kind of thing.
We're supposed to be getting a baton anyway, a stun baton. And anybody got an old Cutlass Blue, got a pair of handcuffs and a stun baton with it. So do you think
they're going to have the cutlasses done?
No. No, I don't expect that at all, actually.
Because the red is still on a roadmap with no progress whatsoever.
I understand that, yeah, yeah.
And 3.8, they said that they're going to push it out before the holidays.
I'm going to be honest. Yeah, no, I'm going to be honest here. I think this is CIG's way of letting us down slowly. By if they dumped everything off, say, 3.8, in one go, then people will be going crazy. But if you do it in bits,
they're still going to get pissed off. Just do it. It's like rip the Band-Aid off. Just rip it off. Rip, done. Just rip it off. Just, you know, and be done with it. Don't pull it halfway and say, did that hurt?
Did it hurt?
And then pull the other half off. Just rip it off at once.
No. I want to keep my hairs on my arm.
Just rip it off.
The thought of that. So I think, yeah, no, I don't think so. I don't think it is going to be ready at all. It kind of makes sense to do the red and blue at the same time. And the blue is for 3.9. So, yeah, I don't expect that at all. What else is there? Squadron 42 reveal, obviously. That's a no-brainer. They have to show something. Do you think they'll
release a new segment?
Well, they can't show us too much.
Right.
We have to be careful what we see.
Do you think they'll just enhance the previous segment or enhance the previous segment, do a side-by-side comparison, and then maybe introduce something new, a little snippet or something?
Something like that, yeah. They'll show progress, but they have to show something new, but not too much.
Yeah, I mean...
Because, you know, you kind of can figure out a few things already from what we've seen.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want to know too much about it. I really don't. What else? I don't expect too much, really, to be honest with you. Maybe I'm doing that deliberately to lower my expectations.
Yeah, I can't think of anything new that they can possibly show us, unless it's one of the new technologies that they're working on, right?
Precision Clan is usually a mixture of everything. So they'll show a new ship, they may show a new gameplay mechanic, so they'll update us on how they may have progressed in, let's say, a gameplay aspect that, you know, we haven't seen much about. Much from at all, like, I don't know.
Probably salvaging. Medical.
There we go. That's another one.
Medical's been kind of on a roadmap, on and off, so I would not be a bit surprised if they actually covered some of the medical gameplay.
And yeah, it's probably some planetary tech then, and microtech.
Well, yeah, we're getting the new planetary tech anyway.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, but we haven't seen it yet, right? So they can show...
The fog has been moved away. Expect. We lost the planetary. Yeah. We've lost it. Now remove altogether. So much has disappeared
off.
Maybe
it's done.
It's done.
It's done. They will not surprise you.
Maybe they're there. Surprise, motherfucker.
Surprise, motherfuckers.
Yeah, I wish they were like that. I don't think so.
Like, open quite disappointed, you get free actually. This, free stuff, free.
I was hoping for planetary fog. It does help to make things look slightly more beautiful looking, shall we say. Mm-hmm.
I want to see that swamp area where they had that caterpillar crashed in one of the videos. That looked so cool.
Swamp?
Yeah, it was one of the videos started talking about how they were explorers and stuff, and then they showed different people and they were going to different areas and stuff like that, and one of them was a crashed caterpillar in a swamp. They had the one female character there in the white suit.
Okay. Yeah,
they might have had the reclaimer in that one as well. I don't remember, but yeah, I want to see that kind of stuff. I want to see more.
Okay, yeah, that was in that commercial. Remember that now? Yeah,
I want to see more plants, more biomes.
Yeah, biomes. Well, yeah, plants would be a really big addition. Base building just helps to fill everything. Well, we could learn more about bases since land claims was an interesting thing that we got last time. So maybe they might expand on that. Because they're going to have to give orgs more. They really are.
Do you think they're going to put more land claims up for sale?
Maybe. I might buy a couple. I should have got one last time, but I didn't. I don't know why. Yeah, I would buy one.
One what?
A land claim. I might get a 4x4 if they have it for sale. Of course, it's going to go up on price.
Probably.
But sale might get one. I should have got one last time.
Oh, they do that with the anniversary sales, right?
Well, maybe the price won't be the same.
No, they did it last time.
Did they? I don't remember putting them up for sale again.
No, I think it was, though, wasn't it? That they had when the anniversary sale, they sold some of the land claims as well.
Yeah, it was only revealed last year, wasn't it?
No? It was longer ago, wasn't it? With the Pioneer?
Okay.
I don't know.
Yeah, it was made available with the Pioneer.
I'm not sure how long ago that was, though. I felt like
that's
it was
2 years ago. I know,
I'm with you, Kimmy. I would love to see some creatures. They don't have to be smart. Even if they're broken, they just sit there while you shoot them. I don't care.
Oh, they've released...
Give me creatures.
They released a galactic guide with one of the... planets some of the Tavarans settled on after the war. They're assimilated into the UEE, so it shouldn't be that uncommon to encounter them eventually. Figuring the whole standing system, you may already wonder why you don't see any aliens, because it's not that uncommon.
We've seen them work on the Banu and the Zeon quite a bit. We've seen a lot of concept art for them.
And the Prowler, so they're working on, so maybe they're going to be working on the characters, the aliens themselves.
I think we're actually going to see a functional space, Banu.
Space
and
chickens?
A functional Zeon. I think we'll see more concept on the Terravant.
Well,
if the Prowler soon,
we might get more detail about the Tavarin then.
Yeah, I don't think the Prowler's going to be done.
No, that's not.
No, but enough. I mean,
that Prowler is behind schedule. I don't care what they say.
I don't know how that development process works though. But I mean, they've figured out the aesthetical design of the interior of the Prowler, as you could have seen in that episode of does that mean that they may know what the Tavarin are, what they look like, kind of what they look like, and what they
they know how they look like because they did have a concept art of them. They look samurai-ish birds, right?
Yeah, but still, I mean, they would have been further along to ship the ship.
Incorporating the trees theme, right? So associated with birds, right? They hang out in trees, whatever, which is pretty cool. But apart from that, they don't have the texture language for them yet. At least that's what they said in the last video that they released, right? And they were saying that they were still a way off. And one of the things that held up the Defender was getting those textures theme for the Banu ships, because it's supposed to be aliens. So I can see where it's going to be delayed, because they are trying to come up with a visual language for the Tavaren.
I like the look of it. It's different. The ladder looked cool, I have to say.
Yeah, that was neat.
That was a nice design. Yeah, no, it's a good direction. It's worth the wait a bit longer.
Yep, but it's definitely going to be delayed.
Yeah. Texturing and all that's going to, and lighting, it's going to take a lot longer.
I mean, it looked like they got the majority of the front end of the ship done, which is probably where the big details are, because the other half of the ship is basically just a holding area, a staging area for people to sit down and wait to jump out the hatches.
It's possible that the video that we've seen might be a couple of months old anyway. So it might be a bit further along than we expect.
So you think they're trying to throw a red herring? Throw us off?
Kind of. Surprise, motherfucker!
Isn't that the usual standard they've had for the last, I don't know, how many years?
Yeah, but they use that, they do the surprise motherfucker with new shit, not with the existing shit. Right? Yeah, the existing this shit, they're always late. They're always behind.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true, yeah. I don't know. Maybe.
It would be nice.
Not this, man.
It would be nice.
Again, with all the sliding chairs, I don't know if I prefer this anyway, because it's like...
What do you mean the sliding chair?
It takes... It always takes... No, but this, no, I mean the chairs that do this. Like, they slide. You turn around and then slide back.
Oh, okay, yeah.
But the thing with that is, though, if you're trying to get into your ship fast, you have to wait for this thing to come, to turn around and come back every time, and it... It's usually wasted a couple of seconds. You're usually like, come on, man. If that thing would just stay in place, I'd just hop into it and jump over it or something.
Have you tried getting into an Aurora lately? The other Aurora chair does not turn
around. Dude, I do the livery.
That is a pain.
And I can squeeze through all sorts of
it.
Things in my van if I...
Nah, it's just a stop clipping issues.
It takes forever to get into the seat of an Aurora.
It's technical.
The slide is unnecessary, in my opinion. It's like, just turn it around. Leave it in its place. Just turn the damn thing around. Let me
pop in that.
And turn it back around.
Yeah, I get that.
The joystick here is interesting.
That's
single
cool.
Joystick. Yeah. Is this actually our first 6 degrees of freedom joystick?
Someone's going to build that. You know that.
Yeah. That's the
first. People are building them now, ad hoc. But now they have a model to go by.
It's I like the look of it, but I don't know if somebody's going to make it or not. That's to be technically quite difficult. I like the struts.
Yeah.
More struts.
More struts.
I don't get it. What's wrong with it? You're not paying attention
There's the video. Yeah. Miami just posted it.
However, I do think that when
Discord, lost and found.
Oh, yeah. But when people were whining about the fact that the man just didn't have enough struts, some people were.
The struts complaints are about the windows and being able to look out the window.
I know.
And they say it obstructs your combat, but it doesn't, because your markers follow across the thing. You're watching the marker. You're not watching the ship.
Some people are saying that the Mantis doesn't have enough struts, kind of like they were used to the Constellation.
That would be me.
After a while, the Constellation... Really? Because after... Yep. I mean, I guess even when the Constellation first revealed, I remember people saying, what about these struts that are obstructing my view? I mean, it was even with the Freelancer when they made that giant dashboard.
It's like they say.
And now they made the Mantis bits. It still has struts, but it just has a little less. And I like the view better this way anyway. So I don't really get it.
It's someone's always going
the
to.
The Connie's a slower ship anyway, so I guess it doesn't really matter that much.
Mantis I don't smaller. Know. The Mantis just—it just looks unrealistic. I thought the Mantis. Yeah. The glass just kind of hovers there, and I don't know. It just seems like a bug to me all the time when I see it. So I think there should be a little bit more. But as any of us said, I just don't get the argument. You're too busy looking at the UI and not the scenery.
Yeah, that too.
You know.
Now, for something like the 600i, where Joran was going butt nuts crazy about it, kind of makes sense because it's a touring ship. You want the windows. But to me, and for combat, it doesn't. There are valid points. You do want clear line of sight. You don't want obstruction. But for the most part, you're usually looking at the UI because you can't really focus on the item. You're looking at the pip, or you're looking at the targeting reticle or something. And you can follow those past the line of sight of the windows. And so you still have an advantage. And Blight just posted an image of that 6 degree of freedom's joystick, and that is freaking crazy.
Oh, where's that? Discord is
it? Yeah, that thing. That's crazy. I would like one of those. 6 degrees of freedom, baby.
Oh, yes. Remember that. Yeah. I wonder how far that got along.
And there's that swamp. That yeah. Thank you, Realm. Miami posted that. Thank you very much. I want to go there.
What the hell was that?
The joystick.
The joystick.
Yeah.
The joystick or the ship.
The joystick.
That's you know, a you know he joystick. He's only interested in tech. Yeah.
Yep. I know when you find these wrecks, all they see are
mounds of scrap or a paint issue. Whatever. We link it in chat, by the way.
Chat? We have a chat?
I think so.
Okay, give me a second. Yeah, it's something again that's desperately needed. Especially for space games. Kind of disappointing on the lack of a proper 6 degrees of freedom joystick.
Never had a reason to have it.
Yeah. These games were dead.
Yep. Now we have a reason. 6 degrees of
freedom. That argument is dead a long time ago.
Yeah. Well.
But why is this one 6 degrees of freedom? What does it do?
Twist.
Yeah, but an extra axis. Yeah. Pull forward, back. Twists left, right, maybe an up and down.
Looks like there's an axis there, yeah. Kind of looks like this whole thing could just twist this way. I'm not sure. I haven't seen that thing before, so. No idea.
I don't have a pair of them. My God. It doesn't look cheap anyway.
I have arrived. Oh, it's custom made by the looks of it. I see all those fucking.
Yeah, you still got all the wires and all that stuff.
Yeah. It's custom made. So I built that.
But if they actually get that working and they get a production schedule, might be worth it.
Maybe.
I have to see it in use first. So I'm calling, we're going to see Banu and Xian characters. Or NPCs, not characters, because we don't get to play them yet.
Or Dvarin.
I'm not sure about the Banu. The Xian, yes, because they're in Squadron 42.
Are they?
Yes, there's hinted of at least a Xian ship.
Ooh, hints.
So, well, that's a ship. You don't have to see them.
No, I think it may be maybe because I believe it's an abandoned ship that you come across in the game.
So you're thinking it's dead Zeons.
So possibly.
Dead turtles.
Dead turtles. Poor turtles.
Poor turtle. They're on their shells upside down.
There's some kind of Zeon rail gun that you have that you can carry around.
Ooh.
We've seen images of that, so.
Holy crap, there's bright red.
I'm guessing that you're going to need that in the game. Yeah, I think Zeon more realistic. Banu, no.
I don't know. They've been working on them quite a bit.
That's what's the point.
Oh, look, a red arrow. That's nice.
To have them in the game when we go to the other systems.
Yeah, but Banu systems are on the edge, and we're probably 100 years before we get to the Banu.
Nah,
I don't think so. The Varian is more realistic, I think, to be shown.
I don't think so. They can move the schedule around however they want, but they weren't really investigating them or weren't really focusing on them early on. Unlike the Banu and the Zeon, so I still think it's kind of
they're still kind of unsure how they're going to look like. So,
I mean, we might, like I said, we'll probably see more concept art for the Tavarans, but I think we'll actually see an actual working NPC model for the other two races.
Oh, that's not what you asked, though.
Maybe we'll see Sadabal.
Oh, there's no use. Just waste of time there.
Yep. You want to see Sadabal? Look up Echo Arena in VR. So that is Sadabal.
Let's go watch.
So we've lost Sadabal then, because somebody else has it now.
Yep. That is Sadabal. You're in it. You're floating around.
Stream is breaking up bad, both in voice and image.
Who, me?
That's not just WeHam
stream. No, the stream itself on Twitch.
Oh, frozen.
It comes and goes.
You need a new computer, Ron.
Or it's me.
Are you playing and streaming?
I think it's me. Let's see if I can fix it.
Let's have a music break anyway. I could do it with a pee.
Yeah.
Let me see if I can see if it fixes it now.
Music break anyway. Pee time. I'm tired of urinating in my pants here.
They got diapers for that. You know that.
I'm not going to wear diapers until I'm 60.
Oh, okay. At least you have a goal. It looks like the stream is still kind of messed up.
You know what happened?
No.
Origin started an update.
Well, let's take a break while it does its update.
Yeah. No, it's fine. I had to reduce the speed.
Yeah, it's frozen.
It just sucked the whole internet out.
No, I'll just play a song first. So that. Okay.
This is Jared, Disco Lando Huckabee, and you're listening to
The Base.
It works. Random, it's only you going up to the server of the server itself. The share server.
Is it still unstable?
Yeah.
Looks that way.
Okay, 1 second. Dun, 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 dun.
I guess we can
be stable now.
We can always work this way, because this is fine.
Yeah, No faces.
It's a radio show.
Like the old days.
It's like real radio.
The real old days where we didn't have video.
Right.
Right.
All right, so what are we going to talk about next?
Okay, so what's going to cause us to riot? This is for Zeus. What is going to cause us to riot if they don't show it in Citizen Con?
Don't show what?
I don't know. Anything? What? Something that we're all expecting?
Yeah, they're not gonna show us. And please, take the plug and take the mad light out of it.
We gotta have something.
Start to moving to. About. Get some bloodstream to go into your head. You know,
we gotta have something. Please, we gotta have something. Okay, what's gonna disappoint you if you don't see it? You nothing, because you're happy just to see any kind of movement, right?
I'm gonna be so thrilled to see the other fuckers just loosing their pieces and loosing their shit. It's fun, regardless.
Yep, Squadron 42 will definitely piss off a lot of people. But I'm pretty sure they're gonna give us some 42.
Why would them showing you Squadron 42 piss you off?
No, not showing.
Because
not showing
we waited 42. a whole year.
I'm sure that they will show something for Squadron 42.
They have to show something for Squadron 42.
Yeah, no flyable concept sale. I don't know about that, but I'm sure a lot of people will be happy about that. A system not ready but coming in like 20XX. Yep, that would be annoying. No Carrick. Yep, a lot of people will be upset about that. No release date for Squadron 42.
No
jump points. I'm just saying, I've been instructing people the whole damn week and they keep telling me that I'm rolling my eyes a lot and looking through the ceiling.
You're allowed to.
So no personal. I think it's stupid, right?
Hey, you're entitled stupid. To your opinion. That's why you're on this show, right?
You're stupid.
You're stupid.
Thank you. Finally.
Squadron 42 cinematic trailer is all we're getting. Okay.
Yeah, that's fair enough. We don't want too much anyway.
No, it's some more flair, just you know, some cool stuff.
There would be very little for Squadron 42. Well, very little still means that there is some Squadron 42.
You know what? COG is crazy. They always pull some stunts, so maybe they got Mark Hamill to show up at Citizen Con.
No.
Maybe there's some new tech. New tech.
The other actors, then, maybe?
Imagine new tech in terms of planet-side tech that's come up.
There'd definitely be new tech.
You'll that's going to delay any project with another 2 to 3 years.
No, I think they know by now.
That is par for the course.
I'm sorry. I'm just trying to use the salt. I get the pepper later to rub it in.
Yep. No, that's a very good point.
Isn't it that they know by now that they just need to make sure that they don't cost too much feature creep and just make it so that anything they do reveal was already planned anyway?
Yeah.
They're gonna make a completely new part of gameplay, then we'll all be like, yeah, something new, more development.
But what about all the other stuff that we're still out for?
I want them to troll us. I want them to troll us so hard that people fall off their chairs. I want to see the jump on rails to another system and suddenly X-Wing fighters are attacking you.
You have entered the Star Wars galaxy.
That would be cool. That would be cool. Unfortunately, it probably would be just Vanduul, but that would be cool if it were a bunch of X-Wings.
And then Mark Hamill was in one of those.
Oh, man. Unfortunately, Disney wouldn't sign off on something like that. But that would be cool if all of a sudden you go through the jump point, you come out on the other side, and there's an X-Wing, and it's Mark Hamill. And he comes out and walks onto the stage. That would be fucking awesome.
You're all amazing.
That would be fucking awesome.
Maybe.
Or just saying, what the fuck did you expect?
That's awesome. It would be cool if they did have a celeb.
I think it's too early. Yeah, it's too early for the celebs, really. Until we definitely know when Squadron's coming out, I think that's too early.
Well, I don't know. Why would it be too early? I mean,
it's a year in advance. We said that for when we expected, right?
They said that the game is supposed to be next year, right? So
and
marketing usually starts a year in advance. So why not?
If they come up with anything major for Squadron 42 this, we know that it's a year or less away. That's the standard. It's an industry standard.
Maybe not Mark Hamill, because obviously he's in the U.S. I would think if they brought Mark Hamill out, it would probably be at next year at the Los Angeles. I think it's next year.
That's what we said before, right? Because it's all so, world.
But if they can get somebody that's in England, I mean, they have plenty of British actors that are already part of Squadron 42.
What's that name of that favorite actress? I never remember the name.
Gillian Anderson.
Anderson.
Oh, Andy Serkis and Mark Strong.
Gillian.
No, but she lives in London, though. Or...
Oh, does she?
Yeah.
Oh, that would be cool. Her, Mark Stone. He's over there, I think. Andy Serkis.
Liam Cunningham can get a quick flight over. Yeah.
The dwarf. The Lord of the Rings dwarf.
You know what would be cool?
Well, he's the actor.
Big ass fucking Vondel.
We've dwarfs in
The Lord of the Rings dwarf, the actor. He's in the game too.
Oh, right? James Ives or something. I forget what it was. He was in Indiana Jones, Raiders of the Lost Ark.
I'm not sure if he's English.
He's Welsh. Double barrel name.
Yeah, but I think he's still in the UK.
British.
Or lives over in Europe somewhere.
God, why can't I remember his name?
I can't believe I forgot his name. But yeah.
He played the dude that keeps saying my precious, right?
He's a double barrel name.
That's Andy Serkis. He's British.
But he's there as well.
It would be cool if they got at least one.
Liverpool,
walk on stage.
I don't see the point. Unless they definitely can.
That's the whole point. You kick off this a year. You know, we're not spending ton of money, although they are, but they're not spending that much marketing money. So they need to start.
John Rhys-Davies. Shame on me.
That's the old dude. That's the Indiana Jones. Just say Indiana Jones old dude. You know what you're talking about.
Yep.
Indiana Jones old dude.
So it would be nice if
John
one of them came
Davis.
Out and they introduced the Squadron 42 trailer or segment that they were going to be working on. That would, and hopefully they would actually be part of that segment. That would be fucking awesome.
It's very bold for them to do that because I don't see them finishing it before the end.
What? CIG is all about bold.
That's like giving a date, you know? We don't need dates.
Oh, 2016? I'm channeling my inner Juntao right now. 2016.
I don't want to go down that route.
2016. Squadron 42. It was
2020. It was the perfect day to launch anything.
I just can't say 2020, but anyway.
They pushed the beta to 2023.
It's not that. It's just as clearly they're way behind in some clear tech that they need. And
not for Squadron 42, though.
I don't know. There's a lot of... I still think the server-side meshing is definitely required. The transition to Vulcan is also going to be required.
For Squadron 42.
Yeah, for Squadron 42.
Because you're still going to have a lot of shit rammed down into your computer. So you're going to have to minimize that as best as they can.
Yeah, and that's client-side meshing.
According to the story, development, they're behind. They're still behind on a lot of the story elements that they need to build out in the chapters and stuff like that. I mean, we don't know what we don't know. So there's a lot of stuff that could be quick wins But if they are true to what they say is that it's accurate, then I just don't see them making their... They're not going to make Q3 for beta. Unless some miracles happen.
They're not making Q3, Q4 for beta.
No, it's Q3.
No.
It was Q2. It got moved to Q3.
It's not
Q3. Probably going to be Q4.
It's Q4. you know it. I know it. Everybody knows it's going to be Q4 beta.
Yep.
Except, the Irish dude that says it's going to be 2021 sometime.
No, it's going to be playable in Q4 2021. That's what I'm aiming
for. I don't know. But oh, you're saying...
Maybe not. That means beta, but not release worthy.
Damn. Now, I hope they... I don't want them releasing the game Q4. Because that's when everybody else releases all their games.
But that's perfect for CitizenCon.
Right? I would rather see them release it probably Q1 of 2021.
I'm testing
so that way there's less to compete with.
No, it's going to be released.
They should ruin the Christmas for a lot of people by releasing it in the mid of September because nobody released mid-September. Oh, sorry, December.
It's CitizenCon 2021. That's when they release it.
That's 2 years from now.
Yeah, I don't want to wait that long.
So anyway, I doubt to have any celebs. It's too early for that.
Okay.
It'd be nice if they did bring somebody on. But
if it's a year, there will be a celeb. If they think it's 2 years, there will be no celebs. There will no push, no Squadron 42 whatsoever. Maybe a little bit, but not much.
Does Chris Roberts count as a celeb?
No. Nope.
Okay.
But it would be cool. I don't know. What else we got?
Good question, actually.
Seems just telling us it's choppy there.
Is it still choppy? Is it?
Seems like it's functioning all right.
No, it's still choppy. Yeah. I still think it's the server, but anyway. How do you reset that server?
Hit the power button.
Ask Pegasus. That's wow.
So I can't think of anything else. I don't.
Did anything come out?
What do you mean, did anything come out?
I don't know. We talked about the roadmap. Do you want to talk about the roadmap? And how so much stuff is vanished?
Moons.
Now we talked about that theory, didn't we? No.
Yeah, we talked about the moons. So we know that they're going to be releasing 3.8 early.
Are they?
Yep. They said they wanted to release it before the break so that they can make sure it's stable. So
camera changes. Advanced.
Oh, they did talk about camera changes.
Oh yeah. Yeah, that's interesting. I wonder why.
But it's only the forward looking and the rear looking. So the rear looking, I guess, is third person F4, right? Like we normally see. What the fuck is the forward looking?
They're talking about the look ahead camera, right? Which is something that you can do while in cockpit. You hit you hold a button and
the zoom. Yeah.
It aims zoom? And zooms a little bit towards the target you have pinned.
I don't know what's wrong with that.
I don't get it either, so that's like what updates? Okay. Dunno.
Okay.
They got gunship defensive maneuvers scheduled, but no work done on it for 3.8. I don't know anything about that. Prowler is still on there, even though it doesn't look like it's ready.
This is the hammerhead.
The redhead. Redhead. The Cutlass Red. The Cutlass Red isn't any... It doesn't have...
What are you thinking about?
Yeah, I know. Couple of guns.
Redhead.
Yep. Redhead, more redhead. Gillian Anderson, redhead.
Yep.
Red Dead Redemption?
No.
What did we lose? We lost the three moons, the shopkeeper improvement. That's a pity. I was kind of hoping to interact better.
AI is
we lost the bartender.
Oh my god, AI is switching right now.
The death animation improvements. Yeah, I like to.
I was. This is funny. Better. I was watching a stream, and they shot this guy, and he was the epitome of the bad actor dying, where he just stood there.
I'm dying.
And then he finally fell over and died. That was hysterical. Then the next guy comes over and they shoot him and he just dies flat out. And then drops like you're supposed to. But that other guy, he hammed it up. It was freaking hysterical.
Oh yeah, the terrain shadows, that's a disappointing one. I'm sick and tired of seeing...
Is that still there?
That's been removed.
Oh, okay.
Altogether. I'm sick and tired of seeing the jagged edging of the shadows. I was hoping to see improvement there.
You know, I don't look at the shadows because I don't...
I see them all the time. It's like dead people. I see them all the time. Somebody takes a lot of screenshots and videos, so I see that every
I guess it makes a difference when you're doing that kind of stuff. Yeah. But when you're just running around and playing, it's like, the only time I care about a shadow is if I'm on the ground and I see a ship going overhead that I need to be concerned with.
That doesn't even occur, though. Oh, not always. Not properly.
Well, I mean, it's a fast-moving ship. Good luck seeing the shadow zoom by, right?
Sometimes they're too high up, you won't see the shadow at all.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we're getting a new sniper rifle.
Yeah. So
hopefully that will...
That looks nice. Interesting. Yeah.
That looks quite nice, actually.
That actually looks like a legit sniper rifle.
It does, though. I don't know, the head seems a bit small, though. The barrel there. But, yeah, that looks cool. Can't wait to get it in any other color but white.
Yep. Sniper rifle in white.
White, yeah.
Only in snow conditions, maybe.
Oh, Microtech, right?
Yeah. It does not snowy everywhere around there, though.
Atmosphere tech improvements. Wonder what that is.
Nicer looking sunsets. That's what that means.
Okay, more screenshots. Okay. And performance optimizations. What's that mean? Are we going to lose our 4K resolution?
That's later. They actually have that on, I think, the Squadron 42, where they have the HDR.
Oh, that's the last thing.
Yeah,
that goes at the very end. No, but performance optimizations, like 3.7 fortunately.
Oh, man, they moved the force fields to the end.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Oh, that reminds me. Where is it at? I saw this and I was kind of excited. Q4, Squadron 42, 2019. Titan suit.
Oh, that thing.
Oh, yeah. That.
I wonder if they're going to demo it in the show.
That's a possibility. That's a good one, yeah.
Maybe it's to put it. Maybe it's ready, and they'll put it up for sale. Yeah.
Money.
Oh God! How much is that going to cost?
Who gives a fuck?
Oh my God! Now let's speculate. How much is that going to cost?
$150.
I would have to say under 200.
Yeah.
Oh, for suit shit.
It's a suit, though. Really? But I mean,
Well, it's a ship, but it's a small ship, right?
Suit. Yeah, whatever.
Think of it as a ship, right? It's a one-man ship. It's small, probably M50 size, right? Maybe a little bigger.
No, it's tiny.
So I would have to say no more than 200.
No, that's
250
too much.
At the max.
No,
more than 250.
That's way too much.
Well, nope. It depends on. You know, how does it really balance out? What are the weapons?
The tonk. Right? How much was the tonk?
I don't know. How much was the tonk? That's a three-person vehicle, too.
They'll make it expensive as they think people will pay for it.
Where's the tonk?
No, I'm assuming. I didn't say I would. I probably would pay 250 for it, but that's me. I'm different.
Fucking made of money.
I have issues.
they have to be realistic.
It would have to be
way too much.
Below 200, I would think, for sure.
Maybe even below
100 mark, even less. 50 to 100.
No, yeah, 50 is too cheap.
No,
50 is too cheap.
Everyone's going to get it if it was 50, huh?
105 for the tank and last concept.
The tank was 105?
Mm.
No.
So there's no way it's going to be any more than that. No way. Because the tank will blow the shit out of any fucking Titan suit, no matter what you have. Yeah, I think 50 to 75 would be more realistic. That'd be an interesting one. That's a good one you brought up now. I think that's a one that just go, surprise, motherfucker, again.
That would be fucking awesome.
Or are we being ultra optimistic here, maybe? I don't know.
No, you don't want me working for CIG. I'd be charging too much, obviously. But yeah, it would be that would be really cool. And the reason why it's still under scheduled is just because they don't want people to know it's ready.
How dare CIG do that to us? In that case, then we can probably
need a little bit of conniving. They need a little bit of conniving.
We can go to anyone then on the roadmap and say, "Oh, that might be."
Well, you know, there's stuff that's never been on the roadmap that they've dropped on us. So why not switch it up and say, oh, it's on the roadmap, but look, we forgot to update it. Sorry, here it is.
Orison Landing Zone. So
exactly.
Even though that's scheduled for 4.0, they'll probably go, ha-ha.
But why would they put it in the... So they put in the... Whoever did the data mining. So in the files, they put all the information for Microtech.
Because I think they're
all the information for it. And you know what? Those might be like just the zone characteristics.
No, I think we're going to get a better star map. So they're going to show us an improved.
Yeah, that information is relevant to the star map.
Mobiglass.
Yeah. Okay,
might be spicing in the improved Mobiglass, so, and we definitely need a better star map. There's no doubt about that. So they might integrate the star map, the web star map, with Mobiglass better. Maybe it's going to show a couple of hours of nothing but Spectrum.
Spectrum chat roll.
Yeah.
Do you think they're going to roll anything out with Spectrum?
I don't know. They need it.
They need a lot of things.
They have to play catch-up. They need to have something exactly the same as Discord. And have proper integration. Orgs 2.0.
Yeah, that ain't happening. Because we haven't heard anything about... Spectrum updates in a long time.
Yeah, because nobody cares.
Nobody cares, but they do update it though. I mean, there's updates rolling out. They even have a PTU for the Spectrum.
Yeah.
If you don't aware of that, you can actually test a pre-build of Spectrum on the PTU. When Turbulent works on it.
So the tank was 95. Warbond, and they came with a bunch of stuff.
Well, a couple of skins and stuff, but yeah.
Yeah.
No, there's no way that suit is going to cost more.
90.
No way.
$100.
No. It has to be less than 100. Double digit. Any more than people will be moaning.
Has it? Does it? Has to?
If you can buy a ship for $100, you can buy a suit that's smaller than a ship that can do way less.
How are you going to get the suit around? You're going to have to use...
a ship.
It'll fold itself into an SU box.
You know
box
what?
And
people will figure it
cargo.
Out. People will figure it out.
We'll make it fit. I know that. Yeah.
They managed to get a freaking... what was that vehicle? They managed to stick that thing in a caterpillar and transport it from planet to planet. So, oh, there we go. There's another possibility.
App.
The Hercules.
The Crusader Industry ships.
One of the Crusader Industry ships for cargo. Because they talked about...
Scheduled for 4.0.
Yeah, and they're not needed for Squadron 42, I don't think. Any of those ships? Any of the ships from Crusader? Are they needed?
I think I thought they said they wanted... Not the Starlift, but the Star Cruiser, whatever it is.
I thought they wanted to release one of those so that we can actually start moving
Starliner.
Starliner.
Yeah, because if that's going to be a common thing in the verse...
Yeah,
they're
going to
need that for Squadron 42. Maybe you can't get on it.
Cities, yeah.
But, you know, yeah.
Just flying back and forth. Yeah. Why not? Okay.
But I thought that's what the Hercules was for, though. The Hercules, again, was like the Banu Defender.
Yep.
The Tonk? Maybe we get the Tonk, yeah?
No, I mean, the Hercules isn't that for carrying the Tonk, the tanks, and the...
That's you know, right, there's no reason why they can't do the Tonk. The Tonk seems like a pretty simple enough vehicle to create.
Is this thing from Jedi? No. Anything you see on screen, Star Citizen.
Everything, yeah. That's in Grim Hex.
It's just a fan. It's a big metal fan. It's a big heavy metal fan, right? Yeah. So Zeus is like, what has Turbulent been doing? Well, they do keep putting their work on the monthly report, right?
Mm.
Although, fail to see it in this month's update. Oh no, wait, that's Corner 42, hang on.
Maybe on purpose?
Where is the monthly report? Star Citizen.
Was Org 2.0 part of the pillars?
Yeah, Turbulent does work.
I don't remember.
That died a sad death.
I know Object Container Streaming was one of the pillars. Persistent was the other pillar. I think we had like four pillars we were waiting on before we can actually have a viable, sustainable game and don't need to do wipes. I don't remember what all those were.
Turbulent supported the release on the RSI website's pages for the Mantis, Alpha 3.7, the Ship Showdown, the CitizenCon microsite. Yeah, okay, yes. So they make that stuff, obviously, the pretty ship pages, event pages.
Yeah, but they haven't they haven't said anything.
No, they work on the future team focus, polishing VoIP and FoIP. And started a new project aiming to review and evaluate architectural setup up to my scalability. I have no idea what all that means anyway, but they usually do write their monthly reports very vaguely when it comes to Turbulent. I'm like, huh? What does that
That's
even
right,
mean?
They did make the launcher, yeah. No, I don't think Turbulent are totally useless.
No, of course not. I mean,
no.
Zeus was like, what have they been doing? Well,
yeah.
But there are
a lot
of
the stuff that they're doing is probably behind the scenes, and you know, just don't really.
It's not very
they're supposed to be building the interface that allows us to communicate on the web or an app to the game, and be able to be aware of what's going on with people that are actually in the game. So that's a big process. To develop, right? So if they're focused on that's a lot of, you know, their work. Maybe we'll see a sample of that. That would be kind of cool, you know, an early alpha of that. Maybe they've gotten to the point where they can actually be on the web and chat to somebody in the game or something like that.
Streamlining service deployment, improving overall reliability, enables easier creation of multiple independent and isolated QA environments. If you know what that means.
Mm. Kind of. So yeah, maybe they'll give us a sneak peek of that. Hell, maybe they'll drop an app. Hey, here we go. No. Now you can chat with your buddies in the game while you're at work. Not that you can resolve anything, but there you go.
Wasn't the Twitch dark mode black?
Mm-hmm.
No, it's gray.
What? Yeah. So it is.
No, so now the...
They've changed it again.
Oh, the box. See, the box doesn't seamlessly... I made that thing black. The title.
It was black not too long ago. But anyway.
Mm-hmm. I need to make that gray. What? Okay. We're over time anyway. Do we have anything else we can go?
I can't think of anything else.
Glasses?
We're done?
Glasses.
Or do we need to go into why we need burlesque in the game?
What?
Burlesque?
I'm all for that.
Food?
let's bring burlesque. Back the Drake girls. Mm-hmm. Let's bring back the Drake girls.
Uh-huh. I think they were just hoes. You know, there's a difference between burlesque and hoe.
Yep.
No. Don't belittle them. Anyway, this is Anvil's show, so they're going to be militaristic.
They'll be wearing camouflage bikinis.
Yeah, there'll be a lot more UEE, I think, stuff.
It'll be blue instead of red. All right, I guess.
Hey, we're down. Nobody
else got anything else? Take us away, Rollum. Take us away.
No, well, then I guess next week we'll be talking about everything they did show. And what did someone make a list from everything we talked about today so that we can go through the list next week and say, okay, you didn't do that?
Nope. Don't worry. No, we always do it ad hoc anyway.
Yeah.
By the way, I don't think I'll be here next week.
You what?
The most important show of all of them.
He won't be here.
The best of the year.
I know.
Where the fuck are you going?
Yeah.
I'm going to go to a Renaissance festival with my friends. I gotta get out every once in a while.
I get it. But a Renaissance festival?
Come on.
Shooting
you rain. Of little faith, Theo.
Big turkey play drum. The loot.
Come on, good sir.
You gotta need to get wear coupons anything? For drinking beer and alcohol as well there?
All kinds of stuff, whatever.
Do you wear Renaissance clothing too?
No, I don't.
Oh.
At least you're savable.
Yes.
No. You should be wearing something, period. Go around with a lute, you know. brave Sir Robin, brave Sir Robin ran away.
Roberts, Chris Roberts.
There we go.
All right, then.
Anyway.
I'll walk around with my Star Citizen stuff.
Maybe I'll find some hint. New,
citizens that I recruit.
Kids. See your kids.
Kids.
I should send you that prize, Zeus.
He doesn't deserve anything. Don't give him anything.
You won blue pants and blue shirt and he won the sack over the head thing.
What sack?
Oh, the bag.
The bag. Yeah, that's comes with that set as well. Oh, it's a full set, so it comes with all the Pathfinder civilian clothing, including the blue headbag.
Is Zeus old enough for the plastic bag?
I don't know.
You're not supposed to allow children near that.
Well, the pants will kind of look nice, I guess. It's not all bad, but... All right. Have fun on Saturday, everybody. And
Yeah.
Enjoy CitizenCon. We'll don't rage.
On the Sunday after that.
In a week.
Yeah, it should be fun. Can't wait for it.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
So much salt. Oh. Hopefully the video will be better.
All the sugar. Yeah. Okay, bye.
Bye, everyone.
Spinning.
Spinning. Round and round.
So support all the time.
I support the monkeys.
Oh, we forgot to talk about
check
that.
Check out the base. 24/7 online radio.
Oh, yeah.
Visit us at thebase.sc. They're professionals.